Welcome back to the course on power quality by eShikshana. This is Dr. Prema V from BMS College of Engineering, Bangalore, bringing you the third module of the course power quality. The third module deals with fundamentals of harmonics, and this is the fifth lecture in this module three. So in this lecture, we are going to go through these topics. We are going to identify the harmonic sources from industrial loads. We are going to explore the methods to locate harmonic sources and to describe the system characteristics in terms of harmonics. So in the last class, in lecture four, we saw some examples of commercial loads and which are the sources of harmonics. So we saw that the sources like single phase power supply, SMPS, and then we have the sources of capacitive banks. These are the, and then we have the fluorescent lamps and arcing devices. These are the main commercial loads, which are the sources of harmonics. So today we are going to see some examples of harmonic sources from industrial loads. When we talk of industrial facilities, the modern industrial facilities, they're characterized by a wide spread of nonlinear loads. So you name it, you have a nonlinear load in it. And all these nonlinear loads inject harmonic currents into the power system. And this causes harmonic distortion in the voltage. We have seen this in the last few lectures. This problem of harmonics is also compounded by the low power factor, as we saw how power factor is getting affected by the harmonics. Because when we have distortion, we have another component of power factor called distortion power factor. And this is further reducing the power factor of the load. So the problem of harmonic is also added by the problem of low power factor. So all these are problems caused by nonlinear load. Also, there is another peculiarity in industrial load that the industrial facilities often utilize capacitor banks to improve the power factor and to avoid the penalty charges. So there are capacitor banks installed in most of the industrial loads. These power factor correction capacitors can magnify the harmonic currents from the nonlinear loads. Also, this gives rise to resonant conditions. We are going to see the resonant conditions in detail. This can lead to either series resonance or parallel resonance, and this may cause the motor and the transformer overheating and misoperation of very sensitive electronic components. So these are the problems caused by the nonlinear loads in the commercial and in the industrial loads. So now we are going to list out a few examples of industrial loads which are actually causing the harmonics, which are the sources of harmonics. So when we talk of nonlinear industrial loads, it can be mainly classified into three types. We have three-phase power converters, we have arcing devices, we have also saturable devices. In the last class, we have seen single-phase power supplies, which are one of the examples of harmonic sources in commercial loads. So what is the difference between three-phase loads and single-phase loads? When we talk of harmonics, the three-phase converters differ from single-phase converters, mainly because the three-phase converters do not generate third harmonic components. So this is one of the major advantages of three-phase converters. As we can avoid the third harmonic current in three-phase converters, it is a great advantage because most of the harmonic components are generated by third harmonic components. But it doesn't mean that it is completely avoiding the harmonics. It has harmonics from higher frequency components, but lesser compared to single phase converters. So this shows the harmonic, the current produced and the harmonics in the current. So the first waveform gives you the current in the three phase converters. This is an example of a current source inverter type adjustable speed drive, which has a three phase converter in it. So you can see that the third harmonic component is completely eliminated. So you can see the fundamental harmonics, which is about 50 or 60 hertz. And then when we have the 150 hertz or 180 hertz, there is it's almost negligible. But we have the fifth harmonic component, and the seventh, ninth are again negligible. See here, you can see that all the multiples of third harmonics are eliminated. All the triplet harmonics are almost eliminated in the case of three-phase power converters. We can see that the third harmonic is eliminated, similarly ninth harmonic eliminated, and similarly we have the 11th harmonic also eliminated. So that is the advantage of three-phase loads, but still it generates harmonic in terms of fifth harmonic and other higher harmonic components. Now let us take another example. This is the harmonic spectrum and the current of a PWM type ASP. So the adjustable speed drive, which is making use of pulse width modulation technique. So that's why they are called PWM type ASD. So the current in the PWM type ASD is, you can see that every half cycle, there are two different pulses produced, so which can generate more harmonics. And by seeing the harmonic spectrum, you can see that fundamental harmonic is around 100 amperes. Then we have third harmonic, which is very less because this employs a three-phase power converter. And then, but we have fifth harmonic, seventh harmonic. Again, ninth harmonic is very less as that it is a triplet harmonic and the three-phase converters eliminate that. Then we have all other higher harmonic components. So if you are comparing this and the previous curve, the previous one is for the current source inverter type ASD, and this is this waveform is for PWM. So if you compare these two types, you can see that PWM type three-phase converters produce more harmonics than a current source type converter. So this is how it is produced by the adjustable speed drive. Now, when we talk of, so we have seen three categories. One is three-phase converters, then we have arcing device, and then we have saturable device. These are the three main classifications of industrial loads. When we talk of arcing devices, there are mainly three types of arcing devices, which include arc furnace, arc welders, and the discharge type lighting. Example, fluorescent, sodium vapor, and mercury vapor lighting system. So all these comes under the category of arcing devices. In this, the fluorescent type we have seen in the commercial loads also, which has two types. One is magnetic and one is electronic. And we also saw in lecture 4 how the harmonic spectrum is for magnetic type ballast and the electronic type ballast. Now let us see the other arc furnaces and arc welders. It is to be noted that the VI characteristics of electric arc are non-linear. So how does this work? Once we have the arc produced, when the arc is ignited, the voltage reduces and the current arc current will increase. So when the voltage reduces and arc current increases, we can consider this as a negative resistance characteristic. And we know that if the voltage and current does not follow a linear relationship, we call the load as non-linear device. And we have seen that all non-linear devices produce harmonic. So here, arc furnaces and arc welders, wherever arc is involved, it has a negative resistance characteristic. And because of that, this comes under the category of non-linear devices. So this is a source of voltage harmonics in the system. Now let us come to saturable devices. So what are these saturable devices? The devices where the magnetic core gets saturated. So automatically we know that the most important of the saturable devices and the most used in the power system are the transformers. So transformer is a saturable device. Normally it is a linear device, but when it is saturated, the curve is shown here. There is a knee point beyond which it is a non-linear relationship, and you can consider this saturable devices as non-linear devices as they go to the saturation condition. So mainly the saturable devices include transformers and other core electromagnetic devices such as the cores, and this can include motors also. So there are some times when the motor gets saturated, and then that time it becomes a nonlinear load. So the harmonics are generated because of the nonlinear magnetizing characteristics of the field. So when it gets saturated, the curve becomes nonlinear, and then the load gets converted to a nonlinear load, which can produce harmonics. Now I'm going to show you a waveform, which is a transformer magnetizing current and the harmonic spectrum for that magnetizing current. So you can see that though we have a sinusoidal supply and sinusoidal output in the transformer, when we see the magnetizing current, when we tap the magnetizing current of a transformer, it has a shape like this. You can see that it is almost like a pulse, and the magnetic or the harmonic spectrum is also shown here, where the fundamental frequency has maximum, and then you have the third harmonic component and the fifth harmonic. Significantly, you have third and fifth harmonic component. But even though it has a harmonic distortion in it, the transformers are not as much of a concern as the electronic power converters or arcing devices. But their effects are noticeable, particularly on utility distribution systems where there are hundreds of transformers. So if you take only one transformer or two transformers, it is the effects are not as high as other electronic or power converter devices. But when we talk of the distribution systems, utility system, where we have hundreds of transformers, we can see an effect of this. And particularly, it is very significant when there are very less loads, then it comes significant. And particularly when the load in the system is very less, you can say early morning times, when the load is really low, that time the voltage rises, and then it is more visible. So if you are measuring this in the early morning time or when the loads are very less, that time this comes predominant. Now the waveform here is for a single phase star connected three phase transformer. Here you can see that there are pulses and the current is obviously containing a large zero sequence harmonic. So we know that the third harmonic belongs to the zero sequence category. And if you have an ungrounded star, or if you have a grounded star, what happens? The current gets added and it goes to the neutral. So there will be a slight overloading of the neutral. So these are the main sources of harmonics in commercial and industrial load. So we have seen the power converters, mainly switch mode power supplies, single phase supply and three phase supply. The difference is that in three phase supply, you can avoid the triple and harmonic component. Then what other devices we have seen? We have seen the lighting where the nonlinear devices are mainly fluorescent lamps. Then we saw arc devices, which consist of arc furnace, then the other arc lighting devices like mercury vapor, fluorescent, etc. And we also saw there are some saturable devices like transformers and motor cores, which can also be nonlinear at times. And all these sources produce harmonics, and the harmonic spectrum, what we have seen, show that they are all significantly higher. Now let us see how we can locate these harmonic sources. So this harmonic sources can be anywhere in the system. It can be either in the commercial loads or it can even be in the industrial loads. So how exactly can we locate the harmonic sources? Is there any way to specifically to locate the harmonic sources? Yeah, there it can be located. So the figure shows that there is a system, the supply side, and then there are two loads which are shown, which are said to be nonlinear loads. So on a radial utility distribution feeders, and if we have an industrial power plant, there is a main tendency for the harmonic current to flow from the harmonic producing loads to the power system source. So that is what we are seeing in this figure. We can see that the direction of the current is opposite. It is going from load to the source. So this is a general tendency of the harmonic current to flow from the load to source. which is shown here. And when we have this, we can observe that there's a bulk current flows from the load to the source. Now, how is it helpful for us? If we have a monitoring quality monitor, which is capable of reporting the harmonic content of the current, then we can measure the current at each branch of the power system and see exactly from where it is coming. Because if you are measuring the current at every branch, that the branch after this particular load may not have the harmonic current in it. Only the branch before that will have the current. So if you are particularly checking the power harmonic current and the harmonic component of the current using a quality monitoring device, it is possible to locate the sources where these harmonic currents are coming from. But there is one problem with this, that most of the industrial loads will have the capacitive banks in it. So what happens if you, I'll show the figure for that. Suppose, see in this figure, this is similar to the first figure what I have shown. But here we have two loads. We have the non-linear load, and then we have a capacitor. This capacitor is said to be the capacitor bank of some industrial power plant. So what happens when we have a capacitor and we have the line impedances in the transmission line, and we have a shunt capacitance, which is the capacitor bank. Now, when the impedance of this comes as a resonant circuit, and the resonant frequency of that particular circuit with the capacitor and the line impedance or the short circuit impedance, then there is a resonant happening. And if that frequency matches with any of the harmonic components in any of the loads, then what happens? A resonant happens, and all the that particular harmonic current tends to flow to the capacitor bank than the source. So at that time, but actually these capacitor banks are not harmonic sources. We know that capacitor does not produce a harmonic, but it can give a fault indication that that is a capacitor, mean harmonic source, because the current is flowing towards the capacitor. It is not, it is flowing towards the capacitor not because it's a harmonic source, but because of resonant condition. So this can give a false information. So generally, when we are locating harmonics with in this method, what we have to do, first we have to disconnect all the capacitor bands from the power system and then to measure the harmonic. So this is one of the methods to locate the harmonic, which is the simplest method. There are other methods available which are used by the power engineer. So I have just given you an example of how we can locate the harmonic sources in the power system. So I will have a recap again. We have, from the beginning, we saw the fundamentals of harmonics. We saw all the parameters of the harmonics. We saw harmonic indices. And then we saw what are the main sources of loads which can produce harmonic. They can have industrial loads and capacitive loads. And also, if you have several loads in the power system, we are finding out, or we are giving an example of a method which is used to locate the harmonic sources in the system. So this is what we have seen so far. Now we are moving on to the next topic, which are the system response characteristics. So far we have seen the harmonic sources, but there are system parameters like the impedances or the capacitor banks. All these also are responsible in some manner. So we have to see how the system response is for all these system parameters like impedance and capacitance, and the response of the power system at each harmonic frequency. Because why we are telling it? Because they are just not because they are not producing a harmonic. System components never produce harmonic, but they have a significant effect on the harmonic frequency, because the system reactances vary with respect to the frequency. So for each harmonic frequency, the system reactance will be different. So it is very important to analyze the system characteristics under harmonic conditions. When we have sinusoidal response there is no problem at all, everything works fine. But when we have distortions and when we have harmonic components in the system, that time the system response also varies with harmonics. So we have to see how they are acting on it. Now, when we are talking about the system characteristics, there are mainly three primary variables which affect the system characteristics. They are the system impedance and the presence of a capacitor bank and the amount of resistive load in the system. So let us see how they are affected by the harmonic, why they are important in the system characteristics. So when we talk of system impedance, one of the most frequently used quantities to in the analysis of harmonic on power system is the short circuit impedance to the point on a network at which a capacitor is located. So it is called the overall equivalent impedance is called a short circuit impedance. Now, this short circuit impedance is significantly important when we have a capacitor to a point where the capacitor is located, which can be computed from the, so your system short circuit impedance, which is shown as ZSC in the equation, which is a sum of RSC and the reactor, the resistances and the reactances in the system line. And how can we calculate that? We can either compute it if you know the MVA rating of the MVA rating and or if you know the short circuit current. So if you know the MVA rating, it is a ratio of KV square by MVA, short circuit MVA rating. Or if you know the short circuit current, then we can take the ratio of the voltage to the root 3 times the short circuit current. So which can give you which can quantify the short circuit reaction in the system. So now we know that the inductive reactance portion of this. So this can have inductive reactance and capacitive reactance due to the capacitor banks in the system, right? So we all know that the inductive reactance portion changes linearly with the frequency. But one of the common errors what people make is to take this inductive or impedance or the inductive reactance constant. In the sense, you take it only for the fundamental component. But it is to be noted that the inductive reaction is varied for every harmonic component in the system. So the reactance at the hth harmonic is determined by H multiplied by the fundamental reactance. So reactance of the fundamental component multiplied by H will give you the hth harmonic component. Thus, it is very important to calculate the inductive reactance or the reactance of the short circuit impedance for every frequency separately, because it varies with the harmonic frequency also. And in most of the power systems, we generally assume that the resistance is not varied, right? Resistance is almost constant whenever the frequency changes. But in all the cases, that is not true. So where does this vary? In the case of lines and cables, there's a skin effect. And we have been discussing this earlier also, that this harmonic increases the skin effect of the lines and cables. You remember in the first lecture, I was just overall briefly explaining about the effects and the causes of harmonics. There I took the case of cables, where we saw that the harmonic component increases the skin effect in the cables. So when the skin effect is increased, then the resistances will vary approximately by the square root of the frequency when the skin effect is significant. Generally, we neglect all the skin effects and we assume that the resistance does not vary with frequency. But with effect of skin effect, when the skin effect is significantly high, then the resistance of the cable varies approximately by the square root of the frequency. So So that means there the resistance is also varying with respect to frequency. So in the case of harmonic, the resistance also is not a constant. Only one exception to this rule is with the transformers. So in because we have eddy current and stray eddy current losses in the transformer, in transformer it may be almost constant, but it is not the case with the cable, where the skin effect has a significant effect on the value of resistance. So we should take care of all these components. So I have told that the system parameters depending upon the three factors in the system. What are those? I'm just going back. So this is three factors are system impedance, the presence of a capacitor band, and the amount of resistive loads in the system. So all these three parameters affect the system performance. By system impedance, we are calculating the short circuit impedance of the system, where the inductive reactance, we know that inductive reactance varies with frequency, but when we are calculating for harmonic components, we need to calculate the inductive reactance for every harmonic separately. So if you have the fundamental reactance for the fundamental component, then the several harmonic components, you will have to multiply that particular value of the harmonic in it. So x harmonic will have h into x1. So that is how the system impedance varies. Now in the presence of a capacitor bank, when we have a capacitor bank, that will affect the short circuit impedance of the system, and accordingly we need to calculate the short circuit impedance. And then when we are coming to the resistive loads, even the resistive loads vary with frequency when we are taking a significant value of skin effect. So these are the main three parameters which we are considering. So I will show you one curve where this is showing variation of impedance with respect to frequency. So it's almost linearly varying. This is for an inductive system where there is no capacitance. Now, when we have capacitance, we know that we have shunt capacitance in the power system. And these shunt capacitance can dramatically alter the system impedance variation with frequency. The capacitors as such do not create harmonics, but it can have severe harmonic distortion, which can affect the system performance sometimes. So when it happens, mainly when we have the capacitance acting with other system parameters to cause either series resonance or parallel resonance. And we see that here the capacitance is inversely proportional to frequency. We can also calculate it as kV square by MVAR, if you know the MVAR rate. So what we have seen today are the main system parameters which can affect the harmonics or which can be affected by the harmonics in the system. And in the next class, we are going to see how these parameters are getting affected by the system. What are the real effects of the resonance and how it is affecting the system characteristics in the system. Hope you are enjoying the session. So this is the end of lecture 5. In the next class, will be lecture 6, and we will be learning more about harmonics and more about the causes and effects of harmonics. Thank you very much.